Hello!
Welcome.
It's Revenge.
How are we doing?
Now, me and brother are big fans of stouts and all stouts. We've got a brewery that's new to us, Blue Monkey Brewery, and they're Silverback in the USSR. Now, when I saw this bottle initially, it reminded me that back in the USSR, you know, is it Rocky or something like that?
Yeah, those, what, 1980s?
Yeah, 1980s pop tunes, and it's like the singing. The other bit was a Silverback, because the Silverback is a pretty cool character.
Well, it's the biggest of the monkey range.
Yeah, he's a badass. You wouldn't want to mess with him. Andrew's little Belgian guy. Yeah, this is an Imperial Russian Stout, 10.5%. I think we had the Courage one a few weeks back, didn't we? That's the initial Imperial Russians.
Yeah, the Russian,
It's very
brownish.
Yeah, close. It's almost like molasses. You know, like what's that? That coffee drink that it comes in a bottle and you add it.
Cafe.
Yeah, it pours like that. Then just there's not much head. Yeah, it's pouring like that. Cocoa head, would you say, Andrew? Imperial Russian stouts were brewed in the 18th century by English brewers for export to the court of Catherine II of Russia. Brewed strong to survive a long sea journey on the voyage, they developed an incredible depth of flavour.
That one.
Strong hints of licorice.
Yeah, I'm going to say. That one is more or less coming off like a little coffee, chocolate almost.
Definitely
maybe a bit of cocoa. Going on a bit of like licorice.
Yeah, you get that initial syrupy, licoricey taste initially. Not the alcohol though.
No, you don't. It's quite tasty, actually.
The aftertaste, you do, like you say, what's this, like a coffee cream.
Yeah.
With chocolate.
Camp cafe or something.
It's where you add it to the coffee.
Yeah.
To make it more creamier and stuff like that.
Mm.
It poured like that.
I think that's a coffee liqueur.
It does smell like coffee liqueur. You're getting more of the chocolate in the aftertaste than anything else. But it's more, the biggest aroma and taste is licorice.
You do get like almost intense bite there, but then it just smooths off and just, you get that lovely
you get a little bit of dates. I mean, dates are really nice to munch on.
Dates and prunes or...
Yeah, I quite like this. It's very similar to the Courage one we had a few weeks back.
But it is nice though.
But we initially bought it because it has monkeys on it. We don't love monkeys.
Only the monkeys.
Yeah, this is the second one that we've had from this brewery. We had the IPA. US Ape earlier. This is one out of two.
I mean, I think this one's probably better out of the two.
Yeah, I mean, the thing about this is the alcohol is almost hidden with this, but the US Ape, which is lower, 7.5, which is 3% lower, and you could tell the alcohol in that, couldn't you?
Yeah. It's
quite Moorish. There is an aftertaste of coffee, like Andrew says, and prunes, and a bit of the dates. That's nice. Little coffee, like I say again.
Creamy coffee.
Would you buy this again? I'd buy it as a special treat. I mean. Right, the bottle was £3.30. It was worth it. It's Imperial Russian Stout.
Well, yeah, but it is worth it. Yeah.
Mean,
so.
Yeah, like, I'll show you the information. Yeah, I'd buy this again. I'd probably age it a little bit more to get more softer. And...
Yeah, I mean, you could probably age this.
Well, 10.5%. Anything above 6%, I think it is, that you can age.
You got May 2014.
Yeah. But, yeah, really nice beer. You take care.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.